macOS Tahoe is currently in public beta and is due to ship to everyone this fall. And there is some killer features in it that I want to highlight. This video is sponsored by Clean My Mac. Let's get into it. The obvious new change, well, actually maybe not because it's transparent, is liquid glass. Now I'm going to save most of my comments about liquid glass for my iPadOS walkthrough, which is kind of the official, like the OS betas are out. That's when that drops, because technically this is still a beta. But there are a few specific changes in macOS Tahoe that I do want to highlight that I think some people would like. First, app icons are no longer limited to light mode. Under System Settings, Appearance, there is now an option for dark mode, tinted, and the new clear option. Now, I haven't been a fan of the tinted option in iOS. They make it really hard to quickly distinguish app icons. And the clear, while they look nice for demos, using them can be difficult. Personally, I just like dark mode, so I just keep all the icons in that. The menu bar's background is now gone. The icons and menu now just sit right on top of your wallpaper. This took me a minute to get used to, but once I did, I actually really liked it. If for some reason you do want the background back, go into System Settings Menu Bar and turn on Show Menu Bar Background. The menu bar and control center got a few other changes. In Control Center, there are a bunch of new controls you can add. You can run a shortcut, there are tile window controls along with hiding and showing the dock, expose and app expose, there's recognize music, take a screenshot, set a timer, turn on your screensaver, enable a bunch of different accessibility controls, and a few more. These controls aren't just limited to being added to Control Center. You can also add any of them to the menu bar. This way you can get quick access to controls you use often. Just drag and drop a control on the menu bar. You can rearrange any of these in here as well, or just remove items. But that's not all. You can also create your own custom groups of these controls, essentially your own custom control center pages. When in the Edit Controls menu, hit the plus button next to the Control Center. When in the Edit Controls option, hit the plus button next to Control Center. From here, you can drag and drop any controls into the group. There's also a limited set of symbols you can pick from to represent this group. Right now in the beta, you will only see first-party Apple controls, but developers will be able to update their apps to support this new control feature set. To me, this is the future of the menu bar. Older menu bar apps like Fantastic Al's Calendar can't be put in these groups. To me, this is Apple saying this is the future. A big finally for me is there is now system-level controls for what goes in the menu bar. Previously, developers could lock their item into the menu bar, so even if you held down Command and tried to drag it out of there, it wouldn't go. Now you can go into System Settings Menu Bar and turn off any of the new controls, but more importantly, any of the older menu bar items. iPhone Live Activities now also appear in the menu bar. When your iPhone is nearby your Mac, these will automatically start. I'm loving how much of the gap Apple is bridging between the iPhone and Mac by bringing features like notifications from your iPhone and Live Activities to the Mac. When I sit down at my desk, I actually rarely have my iPhone next to me because I can do everything from my Mac or my iPad. This video is sponsored by Clean My Mac. Clean My Mac is the best application for keeping your Mac running smoothly. Whether you're needing to reclaim drive space, optimize performance, or protect your Mac, Clean My Mac can handle it all. They have a new feature that's all about cleaning up your cloud storage. I know for me, I tend to just save everything and never delete stuff. This has caused me to have to buy a bunch of extra storage and various cloud services. With Clean My Mac's Cloud Cleanup feature, it can take a look at your iCloud, Google Drive, or OneDrive storage and make recommendations on files to delete. All of this happens locally on your device, so your data is safe. The recommendations it gives you are based on file size, synced and unsynced files. You get to pick what gets deleted and what stays, so nothing will get accidentally deleted by the system. I ran this against both my iCloud and Google Drive accounts and found a lot of stuff I didn't need anymore. I was able to save so much space. Like I mentioned, Clean My Mac has a bunch of other utilities built into it as well. From Smart Scan, this will optimize your Mac based on a variety of scans and tools. Cleanup will remove system cache files, development junk, and unnecessary files, perfect if you don't have a lot of drive space free. Speaking of, Space Lens will show you how your drive space is being used in the form of bubbles of various sizes. Go check out Clean My Mac today. I'm going to put some links in the description below so you can go check it out. There's a 7-day free trial of Clean My Mac so you can see how it works for you. And then if you want to purchase it, use code ChrisLolly, all one word, and you can get 20% off. My thanks to Clean My Mac for sponsoring this video. Spotlight got one of its biggest updates, well, ever. Spotlight now has a tab system, but it also works like it always has to a degree. You can hit command space and type whatever you're searching for, app, file, email, whatever. Spotlight also seems a lot faster, but I haven't exactly been able to measure it on a like-for-like Mac on, you know, the previous version of macOS and macOS Tahoe. When triggering Spotlight, you will see these new tab buttons when moving the cursor over Spotlight. There's tabs for apps, files, actions, and clipboard history. Each one can be accessed with a keyboard shortcut of Command 1 through 4. The numbers are associated with the order of tabs I mentioned. These tabs are a way to filter your results, but also show recently and frequently used items. But you can always just trigger Spotlight and ignore the tabs. Type what you are searching for, and it will show the results for that, no matter what you are looking for. When going to the new Apps tab, the top row is suggested apps based on your usage. Under that is your full app list in alphabetical order. You can scroll through this list or just start typing to filter. There will also be app category filters at the top as well. So if you want to see all of your productivity apps or utilities, you can. The Files tab shows suggested documents up top. Under that, there are recent documents. The Actions tab is probably the most interesting one. macOS will suggest actions based on how you use your Mac. You can do things like send messages or emails, start a timer, create an event or reminder, and more. You can even assign keyboard shortcuts to these so you can quickly run them. I really like the ability to fire off a message from Spotlight without needing to open up the app. This has really helped me stay focused. The last tab is clipboard history, and this is a big finally. Anything you copy will show up here. You can select an item and hit enter, and it will insert it into your document. You can also hit the copy symbol, and it will add it back to your clipboard. Depending on how you use a clipboard manager, a big issue with Spotlight's version is it only keeps your history for up to 8 hours. For me, this wasn't a big deal. Normally, if I need access to something again, it's pretty quick after I've already used it. I don't go back days. But if you use a clipboard manager, like a snippet manager, where you like keep like your address and email addresses and phone numbers and all sorts of stuff in there, this could be an issue. Apple should probably just make a proper snippet manager and put those two things as separate. Stuff from your clipboard history and that actions list will show up in the general Spotlight list. Meaning if you just hit command space and start typing, you know, messages or whatever, those actions, that clipboard history, if that's in there, that will show up in that list. So you don't really need to jump to these tabs unless you really want to specifically filter or use the GUI elements. Overall, the new Spotlight is my favorite feature in macOS Tahoe, and I really hope it comes to the iPhone and iPad next year. You'll probably notice a new apps app in your dock after installing Tahoe. This is the new app launcher that replaces Launchpad. It's just the apps tab from Spotlight, not really anything special. If you're used to using command space to launch your apps, you can probably just take this out of your dock. Shortcuts finally got background automations on the Mac. I'm not really sure what took them so long for this one. This has all the stuff you would expect from iOS and iPadOS. There are time-based triggers, alarms, email and messages, Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, opening apps, battery level and charger, and focus modes. But there are two categories I really want to focus on in this video. First is file, folder, and external drives. These can be used to watch folder, files, and external drives. So if you have it look at a file, and if it ever gets modified, it can fire off a shortcuts trigger. For folders, anything that is added, modified, or removed to a folder will fire off a shortcut. For external drives, you can first specify a certain drive or pick any drive that gets plugged into your Mac, and then run a shortcut when something is either connected or disconnected. There is a lot of potential here with shortcuts always being able to watch folders and files. There's a lot you're going to be able to do with this. The other category I want to talk about is when a monitor is attached or removed. So if you have a laptop or even a desktop, whenever a monitor is plugged into it or disconnected to it, it can fire off a shortcut based on that. Now, I already made a video about all the new shortcut actions in iOS, iPadOS, and macOS 26. I'll put a link to that in the description below so you can go check it out. macOS also got a few new apps, Journal, Phone, and the Games app. These are really interesting apps. I'm actually going to save going into detail about these apps for my iPadOS walkthrough. One, I think they're a little more interesting on the iPad, and two, I'm just going to go into so much depth in that video. Trust me, subscribe to it. Even if you don't have an iPad, there's going to be a lot in there for iOS and Mac users as well. So I want to hear from you all. What is your favorite macOS Tahoe feature? Let me know in the comments below. My thanks to Clean My Mac for sponsoring this video. If you liked the video, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe if you haven't already, and have a great day.